Hi everyone, Poncho, Nicole, Dobbo is it, and we are going to make a buttonhole afterwards. You can either knit it or you make it afterwards. When you knit it, you have to take care that you knit it every time and at the same places where you want it to have. You can also decide, if you think that's a little bit hard, to do it afterwards. Okay, take 4 pieces of scrap yarn. We have to weave in the stitches. I'll advise, look at the single knitted one. Also there you can see how it's done. You weave in the legs of one stitch every time and you pull it through. And you do that 4 times. Okay, that's because when something goes wrong, it will hold the stitches. You don't have to repair that much. Okay, here's where the marker is, and here you see the other stitches, and you do the same at the other side. You weave in ends. Okay, you're working the buttonhole from the good side of the fabric. So, this is where I want to have it. You get it off the fabric and then you are going to serge. Okay, this is where you see a yarn running and this is the one you are going to cut. 3 stitches out of the edge and just one by one try to get 3 stitches out of the edge, because my fabric was a little bit small, it won't work at this moment. So either you take a new scrap yarn or you use the old one, because and you put it through the stitch that appears. Here's a weaving ends, you have to take care of that. And here's the other one. And as you can see, there is no stitch moving around here. So then I know I have to be at the wrong side of the work. Because they are connected. Just pull a bit at it. Just look which one is moving and that one you'll take out. Okay, as you can see over here, there's another stitch. And either you decide to take a new piece of scrap yarn or you just use the one that you weaved in. Hold it, put the one through. Here's one, and there are always 2 at one side of the buttonhole. So you just take a closer look, and this is the first side you have finished. There's one piece and here's the other one. So you're going to the wrong side of the fabric and you just look what's happening. And this is the stitch we wanted to have. So we cut this one off and this is a stitch we want to have to weave in ends. Go to the other side, okay, and here you see one by one, and here's one, here's one, and you just go and check the other side where the cut off pieces are, which you are going to weave in at the wrong side of the work. Okay, just pull them a little bit, make a knot. This one is up, the nut, and this one is under, this stays under, and this stays above. And this is a knot that is not easy to untie. Weaving ends. Okay, here's one at the wrong side. Then you are going to take a closer look. Here's the other one. Put it back to the wrong side. Just pull it gently, make a knot, weaving ends, and then the crochet hook will appear. And the weaving ends, it's better to do it before using the crochet hook. So, this is what we'll see. Here's one on the stitch, it won't ladder. And this one is also on the stitch, it won't ladder. Put out the pieces of scrap yarn, which are still on the fabric, and then the work is going to begin. I take another cloth color, I do it like this, and this is the loop I'm going to use. You're working from the good side, and always do it the same way. This is the stitch on the good side, and on the back side, or on the wrong side, there's also a stitch. So you take them both. You put the loop on the crochet hook, put it through. That is your first one. And you're going to search the stitch that is next to it, and that's the one on the scrap yarn. Don't let it twist. Put out your scrap yarn, put your crochet hook through the buttonhole, because then you have to put the other one. Don't let it twist, put it on your hook, pull out a piece of scrap yarn, take your working yarn, not the weaving ends, put it around your crochet hook, just pull it through one stitch and then the other one. Okay, next stitch, just look close and okay, the other side is having it too. You can either pull it through at once or do it in two steps. Just look, and when you see that your buttonhole becomes too small, you can decide to either use another crochet hook or make the stitches a little more loose. Okay, just look, what does this need? This is a stitch, put it through, and you know, there always has to be one on the other side. Look, this is my weaving ends. I have to have my working yarn, so just check. And here's another stitch, just look closely and take a skid stitch from the other side. Working yarn, pull it through, and just till you have done all the stitches you'll see around the buttonhole. Okay, there's just still one left, so just put it through, working yarn. Okay, then you cut off your working yarn as long as the weaving ends. You pull the yarn through with your crochet hook, and then you still see there's a piece left. The first stitch is a little bit big. So you just pull at your weaving ends from the beginning and make it as big as the other stitches. Then you grab your needle again and we are going to connect them. You see they all have the same shape, so I want to have the same shape to close it. So this is one is coming out of a stitch. You just do your needle like this through the first stitch, you pull it through, And then you put it back where you started from. And now you see that they are connected. And just look at the tension of your stitches and make them with the second one as big as this one and as many stitches. Now, the knot into it, under, above, this is the one above, this is the one under that stays under, you pull it through and you make a knot and you weave in ends. And certainly an advice, try this on a swatch before doing it on your poncho. Okay, this was making a buttonhole afterwards. Hope to be of help and see you in another poncho video. Bye bye.